in your mind, in your heart, in whatever you do, in the Holy Spirit is not followed, and what will happen, there is darkness in that life. So peace is very important here. Definition of peace is very clear. So peace is one of the wonderful attributes of God. And there are three, our relationship to God, there are three, this is the character of God. Number one, God is love. God is love. Number one, love. I will explain a few, maybe a few comments there. Number two, joy. And number three, peace. These are relative attributes of God. And these three things is the fruit of the Holy Spirit that must and needed to be manifested in the life of every believer. Opposite direction. Because peace is for the people of God. Peace is in your heart. Peace is the quality and attributes of God, and God is saying, I am the Prince of Peace, and because you are related to me, and you have access to the Father, and the blood of the Lamb is cleansing you, and the power in which is flowing upon you, that peace will live inside of you. Without that peace, something is missing, and number two, something is wrong. And there is who we are. Isaiah 48:22, there is no peace, says the Lord, for the wicked. If you are only strong, then there is no peace. I don't want to say you are wicked. Basically, if there is no peace, the heart is not realigned with God. That is something is wrong. Okay, so there is no peace. Regardless, you are talking about beautiful cars, beautiful homes, and then early come to realization, oh, I have the voice, I have something to the Lord. Yes, because if the millionaire and billionaire, they have no Christ, I tell you what, they have all the beautiful jet and all the jewels in their hands, I tell you what, they cannot sleep straight, there is no peace. And that is only realized, the word peace, to the children of God. Okay? So, very important, when you don't, in a person don't have peace, is ask yourself, just ask yourself, evaluate yourself. If you know God personally or intimately, if you don't have peace, ask yourself, am I in love with God? Or, if you don't have peace, or you are diluting your life away from Christ. That is the reason why. Once you turn away from Christ, I tell you what, you're betrothed. And once you turn your back temporarily from Christ, you are the target of fighting, and the hyena will really devour you every day. And I tell you what, once a person deviated from following Christ, especially His Word, what will happen? That is deadly. Take note of the word deadly. It's in the book of John, because in the book of Christian, deadly means there is, check it. Chapter 5, just very nuggets. Okay. There's something here. Let's take note of this, because these are important teaching of the Lord in this period. Okay? But whosoever, okay, very important, once you deviate to other things, our life, and forget the Lord, 80-90%, 95%, and do not discard the Word of God, there's no peace right there. The moment you, a person does not give importance to the Word of God or the prayer, there's something going to happen. It's not judgment. God is not castigating you. Something is happening. The darkness will jump in. Let us have a feast. But there's something that Jesus said. Here's the word of God, 1 John 2:5. But whosoever keeps his words, the word of God, you keep the word of God, in him truly the love of God is perfected. If a person does not the word of God, love of God is absent, quarrel, fighting, trouble is in. Why? There's no word. By this we know that we are in Him. So people that are in Christ, they have the Word of God. Not only know the Word of God, they abide in the Word of God. People who does not abide in the word of God, there is no love of God, and they're in trouble, and these people are not his. And Jesus rebuked the Pharisees, if you love God, and you know your father is Abraham, you love me because Abraham listened to me. He followed me. The reason why you don't like my word, you have no interest in my word, you are not of the Father, you are not following the Father. Your Father is not God of the heavens, there is no rebuke of the Lord. Your Father is the devil. A person who does not like the word of God and reject the word of God, the Father is the devil. Because the last is the one who will creep in and gravitate the energy and worship to another direction, and that is how, and that is deadly. Even today. Okay, so very, very important. So there is no peace. So if you want peace, enjoy the word of God and enjoy Jesus Christ. Okay, so the secret of enjoying heaven when you have peace, your heart in your home. Galatians, the fruit of the Spirit is in cluster. One cluster is love, joy, and peace. Okay, it is this and the thing. Love, God is love. Joy, God is full of joy. In peace, God is peace. And to have this kind of cluster, the first three cluster in the book of Galatians 22 is what we call, this cluster is your mind, our attitude toward God. If your attitude toward God is intimate, you love God, and you desire the word of God, I tell you what, this fruit of love to God, joy to serve God, in peace with God, in peace with other people, will germinate in your heart.
That's just that Galatians 5:22.
Thank you. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, look at peace, long suffering, kindness, goodness. That is your relationship toward social. And thirdly, faithfulness, meekness, and faith. That is your personal kind of discipline about your life, for yourself, for maturity. So cluster into three. One is toward God. Number two is toward relation to others. Number three is toward yourself. So you can become mature. Do you get the point? Proof, not fruits. One Holy Spirit that controls your person. And once you have the Holy Spirit, these nine things will become real to you. It's a matter of obedience to the Holy Ghost. Once you disrespect and then deny the Holy Ghost, the Holy Ghost is green. Okay, it's green. So very, very important. Peace. I will not go in another word, but peace, when the Holy Spirit fully controls the believer, he produces the graces of love, joy, and especially peace. I am the Prince of Peace. So if you are always troubled and worried, not God is rebuking you, ask yourself, am I aligned to what God prescribed to me? Do I have my time of quiet time alone with God when everybody is sleeping? I have my time with God. When everybody is busy with their computer and their movie almost every day, do I have a time to meditate on the word of God that will sink in like a clean water cleansing me from the head, the dirt of my head, all the way to the bottom, the sole of my feet? The word of God is like water cleansing me. Do I have a time to do that? And so, when the Holy Spirit controls your life, the believer, he produces, in other words, to have this peace, yield to the Holy Ghost, enjoy the fellowship with God, read the word of God, and acting upon the word of God. These three things, especially the topic peace, you will experience heaven in your heart. Heaven in your heart. Without this, I tell you what, every day there is quarreling, shouting, fighting, cursing, everything.